Excellent, good morning everyone. This is Rajesh sir teaching mathematics. I hope everyone doing well. And fourth chapter almost fully completed. And I'm going to now, according to portion wise, sixth chapter. The remaining chapters what we missed here will come back previously. Before that, sixth chapter, page number 122, square roots and cube roots. Square roots and cube roots. So, already you have understood about square roots in 7th class. We learned about square root, not much. So, just some notes I'll give you better, some points. So, please, you just understand it. A unit square is a square whose side is 1 unit. But once look at this one. Once look at this here. We have in the textbook only 6th chapter, squares and cube roots. And in this, let us make a square shape using unit squares. And this only I wrote on the board now. So now first you see here in this table, serial number 1. So we have 1 square here. Now, second one more box you don't. In that 4 squares are there. Third, so right. Now, length of the side in units means the side of this length is 1 unit. This one is here 1 plus 1 is 2 units. These are also 2 units. These are also 2 units. Means it's a square shape. Next one, length of side is in 3 units. Means 1, 2, 3. So 3 units. Now, I want to count the number of squares. In first one, how many squares are there, children? Very good, only 1. Number of squares, 1. In this, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we wrote 4 here. And here, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And now here, that we wrote 9 here. Means what you understand by this year? So now, if it is 1 into 1, then only get 1. If it is 2 into 2, then only get 4. If it is 3 into 3, then only get 9. Means here, listen here. Here is sequence. 1 into 1 is 1 square. 2 into 2 is 2 square. Means 4 can be written as 2 square. 9 can be written as 3 square. And 16 can be written as 4 square. This is all you know. Look at the board. 1, how can we write here? 1 into 1, that's 1 square. Next, 4. How can I write 4 here? 2 into 2, that is 2 square. And next, 9, that is 3 into 3, that is 3 square. Next one is 16, that is 4 into 4, that is 16. And next one is 25, that is 5 into 5, that is 25, that is 5 square. Here, 4 square. All 16 word by here, 4 square. Square means we are 2 times already. Already we learned 4th chapter, we discussed already. Square, how we write exponential powers, we have already learned. Suppose 36 is there. That is 6 into 6, 6 square. Similarly, again 49 is there. 7 into 7, that is 7 square, and so on. So now here, these are called as perfect number, perfect square. These are called as perfect square numbers. Means they have compulsory square. 1 given as 1 square. 4 you can write as 2 square. Can you say 5 can you write any dash or dash? In the square you can take it? No, we cannot have any. Because 5 is not a perfect square number. So now, if you see definition of perfect square numbers, the numbers which are expressed, page number 123 beta. See once in 123 page. The given pattern, until now you learn the pattern, no? The given pattern, the numbers are expressed as the product of equal factors. Such numbers are called as perfect squares. Now I said no. This 1 can be written as 2 equal factors. 4 can be written as 2 equal factors. 9 also equal factors. But 5, we cannot write equal factors. We can write factors 1 into 5. But same numbers we cannot write. So, what is the definition of perfect square? I am writing here. Perfect square. What is the perfect square? The numbers which are expressed, the numbers which are expressed as the product of This is the definition of perfect square. Example, if you want, these are all examples. Okay, one is a perfect square. 4 also perfect square. 9 also perfect square. 16 also perfect square. 25 also. So we can have. After 49, what number comes here? If you don't know, 1 by this 2. And here is a 64. This is a perfect square. And here 8 square you can write. If it is power 2, we can say 8 square. And square number, we are talking about square number.
Right, children. Now see here, we have some observed the perfect squares in the given table. One table is there here. If you understand what we discussed now, that is 1 is a perfect square and 4 is a perfect square. 9 also perfect square. So in the same way, we have 16 also perfect square, 25, again 36, again 49. Just now I wrote on the board, 64, 81, and last one is what here? 100. Now, so these, in this way we have to find the factor, what are the perfect squares here. Now, one do this is the children. Once you open the page number 124, children. If you open 124 page here, do this one problem is there here. Find the perfect squares between 100 and 150. Can you say me, children? What is the perfect square between 100 and 150? Okay, so look at the board, I'll tell you.
Asking that first one, find this. Do this, you have to do by yourself only, but I am explaining children in the lecture. Find the perfect squares between first one 100 and 150. So in this chapter we have done all these things perfectly better. So I'll tell you 100 is already a perfect square, but in between 100 and 150, so we will not answer it. I'll tell you. The perfect squares between 100 and 150 are, so let's say, if you multiply it all into 12, that is 144 children. Now, 144 is a perfect square because we can add 12 into the same like this. And 13 in 13 also, 169, no matter, this is, I want up to 50 only, so I can say only, don't write perfect space, not square between 100 and 150, is only one number, that is 144 only. Okay, this is not a, this is a perfect square, but it asks you up to 150 only. And still it asks the question here, second one. Is 56 a perfect square? Question doesn't get you. Is 56 a perfect square? Give reasons. Can you say? No, 56. No, 56 is not a perfect square. Why? Because it do not have two equal factors. It do not have two equal factors. Means a prime, a perfect square means it has two equal factors. Then only can say perfect square. Otherwise it's not a perfect square. So from 11 onwards we have to learn the numbers today. Just I'll write here. Number and square. Yes, also it is different. This compulsory you have to learn it. It is very important. Important means what? Not for examination. You should know these values. Number is 11. 11 square will be 121. Like this. Next step, 12. 12 square is 144. You have to learn. If I ask you what is square root of, what is square of 11? 121. Square of 12? 140. In this way. If number is 13, what is square here? That is 169. If number is 14, 14 square, 196. If number is 15, 15 square, that is 225. If number is 16, 16 square, that is 256. If number is 17, 17 square, that is 289. If number is 18, 18 square, that is 324. And last, 19, 90 square, that is 361. That is 20. 20 square, that is 400. So minimum you will learn all these things. Not only this one, still also you can learn 21 square, 22 square, also you can find it. So learn this compulsory. Once you go through it. Children, in the same page 124, we have tried this there, but try it to the homework. And in 125 page, you can see in the textbook if we have, try this. Which of the following
have 1 in its unit place? And which of the following have 6 in its unit place? Just I'll explain one or two problems in this, and remaining you can try it home.
Look at it. Now, first one, which of the following have 1 in its unit place? First one, 126 square. Second one, 179 square. Third one, others do one thing. First one, explain. You do. Next one is the homework. Okay? Right. Still left. Together. What asking? Understand carefully. It is asking that which of the following have 1 in its unit place? You know all the units, tens, ones, tens, hundreds, place. Now, then what to do, sir? Shall you multiply this all number? 126 into, see, 126 into 126, if I multiply it, then big number to, sir. Then it takes a lot of time here, it consumes a lot of time here. Then how can you do the short way? Don't do this. Simple thing under. Just take what is the number which is in unit place? The number in units place. What is the number? 6. You take only 6 square, this one, 6 square you take. So 6 square. You have here 6. And I am taking this one, 6 is there here, 6 is square root, 6 into 6, what is the answer? 36. In the main, multiply these two here, the last number, last two digits will be 36. But what I am saying here, last number, which of the following have only 1 in the unit place? So, here last number, what is here? 6. So, this won't have 1 in unit place. Like this, you can get your test, which one you have? Yes, for this one you get better. 9 square is there, no second one? Second problem, what is over here? 179 square. So 9 square is there. 9 into 9, so 81. So this number have, means 179 square have 1 in its unit place. Understood? This one is wrong. Can you see by seeing this one? Yes, very simple. One is here, like 1 square is 1 into 1. So 1 into 1 is space. Here, this is not. So this 2 will be. This is the right answer. So this one, what kind of answer is 126 do not have 126 square do not have 1 in its unit place. Now, in this second bit in the homework, in this try this, second bit will be also homework. In 124, try this the homework to you. Okay? And also in 125 also, second bit will be the homework. Okay children, once you look at the board, understand carefully.
See, odd numbers are ready. 1 plus 3.
1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11, so on. Again, 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13. Here, if you want to add these numbers here, very simple. What you will do directly? What you will do? You'll add 1 plus 3, 4. This simple here you can do it. But the big number is there here. We have to count 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7. So this is the answer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Answer is 49. You try it. Answer is 49. And next one. It also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Answer is 36. This one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what am I doing here? I'll get it. 1, 2, 3, 4 is there. That is 16 is the answer. Here 1, 2, 3 is there. 9. And this is 4. So if you add, you'll get the answer same only. But I'm not adding here. What am I doing, you know? I'm counting how many numbers are there. How many are there? 1, 2, 3. I wrote 3 square here. Here, 1, 2, 3, I'm not add here. 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 plus 5 is 9, 9 plus 3 is 16. But I'm not doing it this way. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is, answer is 4 square. This is not applicable for all problems, only odd numbers only. Now here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Answer is 5 square. Got it? So this is one pattern. Means, if you want this one, sum of, this formula is what, you know, sum of first n odd natural numbers, natural numbers is equal to n square. If n means here, or n natural numbers, sum of first n, when is the n? Answer is n square. This is all what it comes under some pattern. So one more pattern also I would like to explain. See, 11 square is there and 101 square is there, 1001 square and 10001 square is there. So if you want to do this problem better, it takes a lot of time. But pattern if you use, very simple. 121, without equivalence, yes, 121, not even. And here, what we have made for 101 square is 101 into 101, no need to do here. So already here, 10201. Same thing. Here 2 zeros are there, no? 1 2 zeros, 2 2 zeros, 1. Or 1 double 0, 2 double 0, 1. Next, 1 triple 0, 2 triple 0, 1. Suppose, like this here, 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 4 are there. What are the answer here? 1 4 zeros. Again, 2 4 zeros. And 1. You can check also, you want to, you can check also. See, these numbers, we have a special qualities there here. What do you know? You read from left to right also, right to left also. Same thing. 10201. You come from right side. 10201. You know, in the English language also, we have some letters which will start from the beginning, ending. Same you get. For example, dad is there, dad, or mom. So if you read from here, D-A-D, from here also, here also, mom. Four letters, noon, better, noon. Four letters. Five letters you want, madam. M-A-D-A-M, M-A-D-A-M. And eight letters, what also there, Malayalam. M-A-L-A-Y-A, Malayalam. Similar ones. M-A-L-A-Y-A-L-A-M. I get it. M-A-L-A-Y-A-L-A-M. So these are all called as what, you know, but these are called as palindrome. This total topic what I discussed here, this is all they are called as here. Palindrome. P-A-L-I-N-D-R-O-M. Palindrome. What is my palindrome here? It's a word that these numbers, it's a palindrome, the word, phrase or sentence of a numerical that reads the same forward and backward. read from forward also, which read from backward also, you'll get same numbers or same alphabets, that is called as palindrome. In this page of 106, we have all these things. Once you go through it, beta, these are called as palindrome. Same number, when you're writing forward, when you read forward and back also, we'll get palindrome. And these numbers are called as palindromic numbers, or as numerical palindrome. This one. The numerical palindrome. These numbers are there here. Numerical palindrome.
Children, okay, once you go through the 127 page number, and I hope everyone understood this class, and in the next session I'll explain 6.1, but one thing you do, after understand this concept, exercise number 6.1, you can try the problems, I'll write on the board,
just you try this one, okay? If not understanding, I'll explain you, don't worry. First bit, second bit, and fifth bit, and sixth bit. This should try at least one way to try. Okay, children? That's for all today. Take care. Have a nice day.
Good morning, children. Good morning. Okay. Now, we are going to discuss about the polar region. Before that, I told you about the North Pole and the South Pole. In North Pole and the South Pole, that is called Arctic and Antarctic. What is there? There, 106 months, sunrise will be not there, and a lot of cool will be there, that we have discussed. And now, we are going to discuss about the polar region. Polar region means what? What is the polar region? Polar region, where it will be there? How the polar region will be there? Now I am going to tell you. So listen now, polar region. You see here, polar region where it will be there? Polar region where it will be there? You see here. You see the polar region. You see on the globe. You see on the globe the polar region will be here. You see here. It's called. You see polar region will be here. Polar region. This is called North Polar region, and here also you see here South Polar region. So you see this part. So the polar region will be here. The polar region will be here, and here what will be there? And then this is called as North Pole. Here we call as North Pole. Here we call as North Pole. North Pole. And this is called as South Pole. It's called as South Pole. So North Pole and the South Pole. Here this part is called as polar region, and this part is called as polar region. On the globe, north side, North Pole. Polar region and the south pole polar region. What is this one? I'll tell you. Now one example, you see the sun. The sun is here. The sun rays here. The sun is very near. That's why what happened. The sun is very near. The sun rays is falling vertical here. So here very hot will be there. Very hot will be there. And you see the sun is near, very hot will be there. And the sun rays will fall over the head. Over the head, that's why hot will be there. And another one you see. Here, what is here? Here, cool will be there. Here you see, here warm. Here warm. And if you take here, it will be very cool. Here it will be cool and cold here. What will be there? What cool? Lot of cool will be there. Here also, lot of cool. Why cool? Why ice? Cool it will be there. And ice will be there here. And here also ice will be there. Why ice will be there? Here and here. Example. Here hot is here, and if you take here hot, equatorial region is hot, and the Tropic of Cancer is here warm will be there, and here also warm will be there, here also warm will be there. This is a globe, this is earth. In earth, climate will be like this. Sun is near, it is hot. Somewhat far to this one, it is warm. Somewhat far to this one, it is warm. But sun is very far to this people, sun is very far. When you compare North Pole and the South Pole, from North Pole sun, lot of distance is there. So sun rays will not fall, and the sun rays will fall horizontal like this. It is called as horizontal. It is called as vertical. So you see, very far. So you should know that why in the polar region here, and in this here also polar region, in the south polar region, that is called as Arctic and Antarctic, we call here. Why these continents? Why this Antarctic continent, and why here cool will be there? Means only you should know that the sun rays will not fall here. You know that you saw that one in rainy season for us, 2 days or 3 days, just sun is not coming, means how much cool we will feel, how much cold it will be there for us. But here once sun will not come. Okay, if sun comes also, the sun rays will fall horizontal, very less, where it will be there. And if sun rays falls also, here heat will not come with the sun. Just sun will be only light to them, only light rays will come. For the north pole and the south pole, only light rays will fall here, only light rays will fall here and here. No heat, that's why there is no heat, that's why these places are very cold, very ice, very strong, totally ice and very frozen. Frozen means you see, whatever the rivers are there here, rivers are there, oceans are there, streams means flowing water. Rivers, oceans, streams, all are frozen, freezing, ice, it became ice. You can't see everything like that. So you should know that. Now I told you why. Why means, I give example now. The sun is far to the north pole and the sun is far to the south pole. The sun rays, only the light rays will fall there. And another one, the heat will not come to, heat will not reach that place. Why? Because very long. Because the heat is not reaching, that's why the places are very cold. And if cold is there, what happens? Lot of cold is there, the liquid part will become frozen, ice, freezing will become, all the water will become freezing. That's why that is ice. And that's why you see one reason, no sunrise in the north and the south poles. There is no sunrise. If sunrise is there, only some 2 months sunrise will come. And if sunrise will come, only light is received, heat is not received by the areas. Now you take our example, our Telangana, you take our Andhra Pradesh, you take Maharashtra, you take everywhere. Sun is giving light and for us heat also. You are getting heat also with the sun. But for them, the sun will visible there only, but heat will not come. So that is the reason. So in polar region, now I told you where the polar region is there, on the Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle, on the north and the south polar region is there. Polar region is totally ice. Polar means total ice. So one reason, no sunrise, that's why total that region is cold is there, because of no sunrise it is cold. And because of this one, cool is there, because of cool it is ice and snow. What is happening? Ice is falling there and the snow is falling. Ice is falling there, snow is falling there. In these regions, you can't see the land. Now if you go outside, you can see the brown color soil, brown color land they are seeing. But there is no choice of seeing there. There you can't see anything, ice. Totally white, you can see like this, white, ice only, totally ice. Ice, total ice. It will fall like this, anti-going ice, totally. Totally, ice only, yes, it's ice only, it's polar region. It's like this, totally, you can't see the land. And this is called ice, you see, ice. So this is called as ice, lot of ice, because you can't see. And every day, snow is falling, every day like rain, snow will fall like this, snow. And there's snow is falling. So what happened? Day by day, it is increasing, like hills it is falling, it is becoming hills like this. So here you see, this is the reason, the strongest and the strongest ice is forming here, because of lot of cold is there. And all the rivers and the sea and the streams are became frozen, means ice. You will walk like this, means you don't know whether down sea is there or river is there, anything. Everything is ice only. Ocean also become ice. You can't see the land there. and that is about that one. That is about that one. And one thing, question is there. Where is the polar region? Now only I told you. Where is the question is that? Where is the polar region? Where is the polar region? Where is the polar region? Is here. You see, north and south pole. North pole polar region is there. South pole polar region is there. Where is the polar region? North pole on the Arctic and Antarctic Circle here. Polar region is there. Polar region is totally ice. It is covered. Polar regions means polar regions on the earth, two are there. One is on the north and one is on the south. Polar regions are there. And this polar region, why they kept name? Polar means totally ice, snow. That's what they call the polar region. And here we get that tundra. You see on the north, some Arctic Circle. Here we call as tundra region. Tundra means cold. You see, what is called tundra? You see, tundra means cold. We'll call thanda. Thanda means cold like that. In this, we are using the tundra. Tundra means cold. Things you can find here or think somewhere here. So here totally ice. But here these parts of tundra region, cold will be there, and here some tundra vegetation will be, some trees and some crops are grown, and some trees are grown here, some crops are grown. That's what we call as tundra vegetation. Vegetation means plants, trees, crops. We have plants are there, trees are there, crops are there, we call as vegetation. So tundra vegetation will be here only, not here, totally ice, totally permanent ice. What will permanent ice is there, the ice will not go. Permanently ice is there. So that is called as this one. Here also permanent ice, and here this is called as tundra region. Some down tundra region will be there, tundra vegetation will be there, they will grow some crops. People will live here only. The people who want to live, they will live here. I am going to tell you how they will live, what they will use, I tell you. But here nobody will live. Here also nobody will live. That is about that part. And tundra vegetation. And seasons, you see here, what is happening? Seasons in the tundra region, seasons in the polar region, what will be there? Seasons in the tundra region means seasons in the polar region, how would it be there? Extremely cold. Extremely cool. How would it be there? Extremely means more. Over. Over cool. So what I am telling you about tundra region, here what? Extremely cold. Extremely cool. Lot of cool will be there, lot of cold will be there here. And totally it is covered by the ice. Totally it is covered by the ice. It's permanent ice. You can't see the soil. If you are not seeing the soil here, how the plants will grow? And also we tell that in the south part, Antarctica is there, Antarctica continent is there. In the GK question only it is there, which continent is treeless continent? Which continent is treeless? No trees are there. So which continent means we should tell that Antarctica is a continent that no trees. Why trees are not there? Why? Because the land is covered by the snow. Total land is, you see, this is a land and this is a land and this is covered by the ice. How the trees will grow? The trees cannot grow. Why? Because you can't see the soil. If you see the soil, if the soil is there, the trees will grow. But there you can't see the soil. On the soil, every day snow will fall, ice will fall. So that is covered. The land is covered by the ice, permanent ice. So there is no trees. But because extremely cold is there. And November, December, listen in this month, November, December and January month, you can't see the sunrise, please you see. November, December, you see, in the polar regions, in the north, I'm telling you, in the Arctic, in the north, what is that in the north? November, December and the January, these 3 months, you can't see the sunrise, sun will not come, totally dark. Totally dark, it will be dark only, sun will not come. And why? Because there is a winter season. And extremely winter season means cold, it will be there in winter season, totally dark. You see for us. Day will be there, night will be there. Day will be there, night will be there. After 5:30 or 6 o'clock sunrises will come. And after 6:30 evening, sunsets will come. Sun setting, how much fact, how much truth is there in the life, you know that. You see, every day sun rises and sun sets for us. Every day day sun rises and sunsets for us in Telangana, Andhra Pradesh or some states, but in India it is. But in polar region not like that. The sun will not rise, the sun will not come 3 months in the winter season. And that's why what happens, and it will be totally dark. Polar region will be totally dark in one time. 6 months dark will be there. 6 months the sunrise will not come in the winter season. Keep in your mind, 6 months totally dark means how it will be there. But there, here, nobody will live there. People will not live here. Some animals will live here, some birds, animals will live, some birds and animals will live, but the birds and animals will shift the place. They know that winter season is coming, so that totally will be dark, so they will move to some places here, they will move from here. Before that, in the summer they will go here, but when the winter is coming in the January and in December, November, December, January, when what happens, animals will come this side. Birds also will come here. Why? Because they can't be here. Why? Because 3 months dark will be there, one more time, 6 months no sun, 6 months dark, 6 months dark only, no sun. So know that, keep in your mind, 6 months day will be there, 6 months night will be there. This is the history only, you don't know that. You see, for us, for the example, you see, 2 days continuous day means it will be a different miracle will be there. And what is this? Day became, night also became day means it's surprising. But it will not be there for us. But here you see, continuous 6 months or continuous 3 months, night, dark will be there. Because the sun will not come. You know that sun is not coming means dark will be there. So that's the development. And the birds and everything will move from that places. That is the development. And next one you see, if you take summer, that is the winter. I told you about the winter. 6 months dark. Very cold, very ice, frozen, freezing, all are same. Frozen, freezing, ice, both are same. Next one you see, the summer season. If you take a summer, February and the March, the summer you see, one day in the summer season, in the February month and the March month, one day, 2 hours sunrise will come. Don't think that sunrise will come, means only light will come and the sun will not come here. The sun will be that side only, like that only will be the sun. Horizontal only, sun will be there only, 2 hours will be there, one day, 2 hours will be there and it will go and sets. Means it will immediately set down. 1 day, 2 hours will be there, 1 day, 6 days, 6 hours will come. 1 day, 6 hours will come and 1 day, 8 hours will come. 1 time, 8 hours will come. 1 time, 1 day, 16 hours continuous will be there. So it is there. Timings are regular, depend upon that. 16 hours sunrise will be there only, or 1 time, 8 hours sunrise will be there only, 1 time, 2 hours only sunrise will be there in the summer season. And only light will come. Even though what happens there, when the summer season, when the light is coming, what is happening there? Some ice is melted. Some ice is melted and that moves from that place. And here, what will happen, you see, when the sun is falling here, and you see, I'll tell you, what is that? Multicolor you can see. Why? Because you know that ice totally white color will be there. Ice will be white color, whitish color will be there. When the sun is rising, the sun rises, so the sun rises on the ice. So what happened? Ice looks like multicolor, like a rainbow colors. Now we will see the rainbow. We will see the rainbow, how the colors will be there. So the sun, only sun rises, sun rays will come, heat will not come, keep in the mind. When the sun rays fall on the this one, on the ice looks in the multi colors, different different colors, it looks beautiful in there. That is about the one. And one thing you see here, 3 months summer will be there. You see, only 3 months summer will be there, here winter will be 9 months. Winter will be 9 months in this polar region. Keep in your mind, winter will be 9 months in the polar region and the summer will be 3 months. And the summer will be and 3 months. And I told you, horizon, the sun, you should keep in your mind, the sun every time rises is here only, it will not come here. Vertical it will not come. You see, we are having here, the sun rays will fall. The sunrise will fall like this here only, horizon only, every time here only it will be. But for us, in India, at 12 o'clock, 12 noon, the sunrise will come vertically. Noon, 12 o'clock noon, and the sun rays will be over the head for us. Over the head, sun rays will be there, heat will be there. But here, heat, but here only rays will be there, sun rays, horizon. And you see, 3 months will be there, and another one you see there, we will call some Lichens and the Moses. What is that? There, Lichens and Moses are there. What is that? We call it as plants. Plants means on the ice. On the ice, some green color will form. Green color is forming. Green color will call as, will tell the green color, will tell Pakuru. Moses and the Lichens. Moses and Lichens means when there is wet somewhere in our near houses, near where the water is flowing, where the water will be there in our houses, green color will form. So that is also called living organism. So here, what type of trees are there? Actually, treeless continents. Trees, plants will not grow. But two types are there. What is that? Lichens are there. Small green one will grow like this. Lichens and the mosses will grow there. And some type of grass that will grow there. That is about that one. And mosses and this one, only two types are there that are grown here. Why it is not grown? Because why it is not grown? Why it is not grown? Because you can't see the land in this polar region. You can't see the land in the polar region. Why? Because the land is covered by the totally ice, permanent ice. We'll call it a permanent ice cap. Permanent ice cap means on the land, the every day snow is falling, so land is covered by the permanent ice cap. So the trees cannot penetrate. Only and here only two plants are there, Lichens and the Moses. And some flowering plants are there. Flowering plants will not plant, will not grow. You will be small for it. That is about that one. And in the next class, we are going to discuss about the polar region. Okay, we will stop now. But the polar region will stop. Okay, thank you.